So when the Pioneer Fire burned almost 200,000 acres of forest land in 2016, Forest Service takes on three different approaches to post-fire restoration and rehabilitation of the burned ground. We look at suppression operations and rehabbing fire lines. We have a burned area emergency response, or a BEAR program, and also long-term restoration. Each of those is a different program funded differently. With respect to the BEAR program, we have land treatments, road and trail treatments, and protection and safety treatments to protect those critical values that are associated with human life and safety, infrastructure such as roads, campgrounds, recreation facilities, and then our trails, designated critical habitat for fish and heritage and cultural resources. With the Pioneer BEAR land treatments, we treated approximately 3,000 acres of ground with aerial mulch and some wood straw mulch, also did some seeding to provide immediate ground cover. In addition to that, we have roughly 1,700 acres of noxious weed and invasive species treatments to take care of lands that's highly susceptible to invasives once the fire burns. With roads and trails, we treated up to 200 miles of roads. We had some drainage reconstruction, and we also removed three culverts and installed two aquatic organism passage culverts to account for the critical habitat for listed bull trout. And then with trails, we treated a roughly 60 to 70 miles of trail to improve drainage to take care of the overland flow expected to come off the hills and that could damage or erode those trails. Part of the protection and safety treatments is installing road signs at portals along the forest highways to inform the public of hazards associated with burned area, rolling rocks, falling trees, debris flows, things like that. And we also treated additional 15 recreation sites where we removed hazard trees. Also posted those signs and to inform the public of the potential hazards post-fire. After implementing the emergency stabilization treatments, we move into planning and implementing broad-scale restoration. That might include road improvements, replacing burned trail bridges, and improving trail drainage, reforestation, and additional hazard tree mitigations.